The episode begins with the filming of a bridge and a relaxing sound in the background, chilling and beating. This boy is punching a tomato bag while another boy groans. Look at that sun. Joking, don't look at the sun, it hurts your eyes. Fun to learn arithmetic. That was the punchline. Wow, I think this guy rubbed his face in the tomato bag. A good bench is a good bench, no matter where you find it. I'm starting to suspect there was no tomato and what happened was a fight. A blonde woman appears, next to her is this flying tapeworm. Always get your meat well cooked. Whoever wins the fight gets the blonde chick. Does it become an 80s movie now? The opening begins with a one-eyed black cat. To be honest, I don't really understand what this symbolizes, but just a few things in life are cooler than a one-eyed black cat. Look at this grown-ass man bubbling around. I'm a goofy goober rock. That's a spoiler, but at least it's not a lie. Today's episode will take place inside that dome, clearly plagiarism from the Simpsons movie. Here's our main character and a potential All Might cosplay. So Tudu has a plan and gets blue, thinking is so atypical for this guy he even changes color. He flashbacks about Hanami making tree roots, she's a monster created by Greenpeace. This flower on her shoulder is what people call a 3D tattoo? You must admit these piranha plants are cute, unless you're Super Mario. What about this big smile? This girl's having a good time while she's topless, so much freedom. To decide who's gonna be the Batman of the duo, they race each other. Tudu started a little ahead, I believe that counts as cheating. A root grabs him, he looks worried, I would be too, I've seen several hentai starting like this. A GoPro in Tudu's head now would make it all funnier. So he goes turning over on that field, and what a firm field, the ground remains intact. Curiosity, if you pause this scene you'll always get a funny frame. While Tudu plays somersault, Itadori faces Hinami. Someone's about to become an umbrella keeper.
Call an ambulance! Call an ambulance! But not for me!
Hinami found Tudu's move so cool that she can't help but smile. Suddenly Itadori got an insight, nothing related to the fight, he just understood the end of Evangelion. Man, what the hell is wrong with your throat? You should see a doctor urgently, like, right now. There's an anime by that name, right? Recently received a remake, I think. They run towards Hinami, but unfortunately they get faceless. Tudu even gets six-packless. Tudu and Itadori beat up poor Hinami. They're literally crumpling Hinami. Her body is made of aluminum or what? Hinami praises Tudu's shoes and asks to look closely. Then Itadori says that Superman is passing by. She asks where, and he shows her where. Tudu is clapping more palm than English in a thrashed match. Hinami is getting a great dental massage, so unique. Itadori is preparing to dig Hinami's teeth with his fist. Suddenly Nanami appears being interviewed in a cafe. He explains a lot about luminous powers that do not exist. And there he goes, against all expectations, he punches Hinami in the belly, again. By always, do you mean 1 hour and a half? So he kicks her femur, do you think this isn't where the femur is? She's not a human, her anatomy is different. She even vomits wine, a wine that is stored in her left calf. Tudu claps his hands again, but this time it's not his technique, he's just indicating his emotional state, he's happy. A happy person in 2021, Hinami can't believe it. So two cauliflowers join the fight, everyone is here. They're destroyed quickly. Tudu and Hinami are fighting frantically, Itadori changes places and she backs up, she's afraid of another flashback. Particularly I'm more afraid of flashbacks. They punch each other, I have a slight impression Itadori gets hurt more. Hinami summons a piranha plant nest, sponsored by Nintendo. Tudu swaps the other two and gets ready to be bitten by the food of his food. The piranha plants fly in slow motion, he should use this time to get out of the way. Then Jujutsu becomes a seasonal rom-com that will be forgotten in 2 months at best. His imaginary friend says those plants eat cursed energy, and Tudu takes this as a smart conclusion. I thought that's the first conclusion everyone had. Have you ever looked at someone and wondered what is going on inside their mouth? Hinami is impressed Tudu realized, intelligence is not their forte. He raises his head up cause the decongestant is going down through his larynx. Itadori tries to kick Hinami, but Tudu shows how to do it. The guy attacks the collarbone, and hurts down until her pelvis. So we see a flashback from a few minutes ago, come on Shonen Jump. Then we see a happy mouse in stage light, and then this weird teddy bear. Are the animators on drugs? So Tudu switches Itadori with this nunchaku, for Donatello and Michelangelo fans. Itadori gets pissed cause he ended up wetting his socks and that feeling sucks. Tudu dances with nunchaku. So he leaves Hinami with a headache until next week, and she tries to leave him with a headache forever. So Hinami puts a hand on the floor, I can't tell which is the pinky, which is the thumb, which is the index finger, or even why does she have a hole in her hand. She uses a power that makes the surrounding trees go into winter. The rose on her shoulder blooms, it reminds me of another anime, but if I say he did nothing wrong some will going berserk. She charges the solar beam, Tudu looks at her cuz he knows it takes a turn to load. Then her power disappears and the dome melts. The show-off Killjoy is here, wait, why does he seem to smile from far, but closely look like he was snorting? Meanwhile, the old man is giving a private concert for the bald butcher. By this smile, I think he's enjoying it. There's also this woman running while talking on the phone. What a long corridor. Then this weirdo dress in a garbage bag appears. This sword is the only way for him to hold someone's hand. These other two girls show up, now it's 3v1. In fact, he's happy. He talks to three different women in the same month. It's a new record for him. However, he feels very pressured and runs away. Gojo wonders which mess he should solve first. Hinami begins to reflect on what to do. Should she run away or ask for an autograph? Gojo solves the bald man issue first. No, he's not gonna get transplantation. Imagine you're already bald and still have your arms and legs broken. So Gojo does two of his most famous techniques, clearly inspired by the Pokemon franchise. Hinami is running away and Itadori tries to stop her, but Tudu asks him to keep looking at his left hand. It may seem crazy, but if your friend asks you for something so random in a situation like this, he must have a plan. Gojo shoots, and his balls go tearing the ground. I can't wait for the heart gold technique. He makes a winning smile, but Mahito is stealing Sukuna's fingers. I want my nail to be as beautiful as Sukuna's. If you like the video, hit the like button and subscribe. I'd like to ask you to watch at least 2 videos of the channel in a row because it helps me a lot. Also make a friend watch this video too. Use violence if necessary. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Bye.